everyone, Matt here with ABI Attachments. Welcome back to another episode of the ABI Dirt. Today we are wrapping up our three-part series on some tractor basics. You all are asking some great questions about, you know, what kind of tractor do I need, and I've got these attachments, or I've got this job, and what should I make sure to consider or look at when I'm looking for a new or new to me tractor. And we've talked about some constraints, we've talked about some unknowns that you want to look out for. We also talked about power sources. Today we're wrapping up our mini series here on connection types. So we've got a John Deere 4 series here, and we're going to take a look at the difference and the pros and cons between three-point and toe-behind connections. Last week we used this John Deere 4 series to point out the difference and kind of just visually point out the toe-behind connection, that drawbar down low, versus the three-point connection. Now again, here on this John Deere, around here, we like to use this hydraulic cylinder, this hydraulic top link for our top of that three-point connection. This week we're going to talk pros and cons, and I want to talk the three-point connection first. So when you're thinking about an attachment that is either, and you possibly have the option, or maybe you're looking at an attachment that has an adapter between a three-point or a toe-behind option to connect to your tow vehicle, the first word I want to come to mind on that three-point attachment is control. When you've got 3 points of connection as opposed to 1 point of connection, you've got so much more control with that three-point system. Because of the design of the three-point lift system, you can lift the attachment all the way up off the ground. Because of that top connection point, again, reason we choose to use the hydraulic cylinder, you can change the pitch of that attachment. And because it's firmly attached, firmly affixed to the back of the tractor, it means that you can typically operate that attachment in reverse. And many attachments out there in the market, especially ours here at ABI Attachment, because we always think multi-use, you can use your attachment differently going backwards than you can going forwards. And all of that just on that three-point connection. Now, the downside of a three-point connection, and where the three-point gets a lot of flack, especially from folks who aren't used to tractors, maybe you weren't born on a property that had tractors, maybe you weren't born on the seat of a tractor, like some people around here, then it can be intimidating at first to connect a tractor to a three-point implement, which is why we've got quick attaches and a lot of things that make that a lot easier, but it can be intimidating to make that connection. Another thing that is on kind of the downside of a three-point system is that now you've got weight constraints. And this is something that not a lot of people look at when you're looking at specs on a new tow vehicle, because when you're looking at the tow vehicle, you're looking at, well, what's the horsepower and what's the weight rating and how much can I pull? But sometimes you forget to look at the weight rating on that three-point hitch system. And typically the way you'll see it is that it can lift X number of pounds at 2 feet out, right? Because again, it's not like the attachment, the weight of your attachment is right up here by the three-point system. If you're looking at an attachment that's 3, 4, 6 feet long, well, where is that center of gravity on that attachment? You have to make sure that your three-point hitch system, that your tractor has the ability to lift that up off the ground. Otherwise, if you've got way too much weight on the back end on this three-point hitch system, well, then you can end yourself up with a teeter-totter scenario and you're not getting a lot of work done when that happens. Plus, it's not safe. So make sure that your three-point system, if you've got an attachment you love to use, if you're looking at a new tractor, take a look at that weight rating. What can that three-point hitch system lift up? Let's then take a look at the toe-behind system. So here again, this 4 Series has this big, massive tow bar, this big, massive draw bar here, so you can connect to toe-behind attachments. This, you can see, obviously set up for a pin hitch system. Basically swap the pros and cons from your three-point hitch system, your three-point connection, to your toe-behind. On the toe-behind, it is way easier to connect your attachments. You can back up, you can look over your shoulder, you can see where that hitch is, and you drop the pin in. No 3 points of contact, you just worry about the one. Way simpler. Also, on a pull-behind implement, you've got way more weight that you can pull because you're not relying on a three-point system to lift it off the ground. You're just relying on the horsepower and the weight of the tractor to pull it across the ground. And if you're looking at an attachment that has wheels on it, well, shoot then. You are not nearly as constricted when it comes to the weight of the attachment as you are on a three-point system. Also, on a toe-behind, because there's only 1 point of connection, well, now as you're moving, as you're pulling forward to that tractor, that pull-behind implement is going to follow you. So some of you who are working in kind of finesse scenarios, if you're weaving in and around things, or if you're in a horse arena and you like to have something behind you that can track right with you, then the toe-behind may be a great option for you. Whereas on that three-point, it's what we call butt swing, that as you turn your tractor, that three-point hitch is, because it's affixed to your tractor, that rear end of that attachment swings right around rather than tracking right with you. But the downsides of a tow behind. If you've got a tow behind, that means then, again, because of that one-point connection, reversing can be a pain in the rear. Some of you are very good at reversing trailers, reversing attachments, but it does take some practice for those of you who are new to using tow behind connections. You also, speaking of reverse, you lose the ability to operate that implement in reverse, because if you've got a tow behind connection and it's hard to maneuver, you're not gonna have a lot of accuracy when it comes to engaging whatever ground you're engaging in when you're in reverse. So typically that means then that your tow behind attachments, they usually lack the versatility of a three-point attachment. They lack the ability to use or be used in reverse. It's kind of a forward-only operation on tow behind tools. That's the rundown I've got for you today on the three-point versus tow behind attachment. What's right for you really depends on your application. It's because work is unique, projects are unique, what you're working on is unique. This is why we love to have our factory reps here on site and have them stay available for all of you to call in and ask a lot of questions, because what's right for you, it goes way beyond hitch type and connection type and goes into the actual goals that you've got for your property, how much time you're trying to save, what are you trying to accomplish. So that's why we'd love it if you give us a call sometime, ask for a factory rep to talk through your project, ask them about the differences between our three-point and tow behind attachments and what may be right for your application. But that's all I've got for today, everyone. Look forward to seeing you next time here in the dirt.